It's Tuesday, New Mexico, and you know what that means, a fresh new episode of the U Sports Report. Unfortunately, Khalil's not with us, but Tyler Ortega is gonna be alongside me all day today. So, I mean, you win some, you lose some.
Yeah, I think we'll be all right. Hoping Khalil is having a good time away from the show out in sunny California.
Yeah.
But it's playoff time, Kimbri.
It is. This is a serious time.
Yeah, NBA playoffs, NHL playoffs, both going on. We had plenty of exciting games over the weekend. Also had some big injury news as far as the NBA goes. But let's go through a little quick rundown of scores from the games from yesterday. Oklahoma City finished off Dallas 119-108 as they win that series 4-1. Atlanta lost to Boston 95-104, excuse me. Of course, the Warriors won 121-94. Steph Curry getting hurt in that game. We'll have a little bit more on that later. The Heat and the Hornets. Hornets able to even it up in Charlotte, 89-85. That one tied at two games apiece. They'll be heading back to Miami for the next one. And the Portland Trailblazers able to dispatch the Clippers, 98-84, with big injury news for the Clippers. Chris Paul, broken hand. We'll get into that in just a little bit. But let's have a look at the, I'd say, the favorites now to win the title since that big injury to Steph. The San Antonio Spurs were taking on the Memphis Grizzlies in the Grindhouse out in Memphis, Tennessee. We'll take it to you here on Around the Nation. As this was a pretty good game if Memphis would have actually showed up to play.
I don't know if this is actually the Memphis Grizzlies or a group of youth that they found and gave their jerseys to for the game.
Yeah, it could be the Memphis Tigers, the college team.
It could be.
From what
Fair
it
enough.
Looks like. As we'll pick it up here about midway through the third quarter. Danny Green gets the steal off the inbounds pass, takes it home and yams it. Now we have Tim Duncan, the big fundamental, going to work on Zebo. Gets it to go, hoop and the harm. Duncan heads to the line to finish off the old school three-point play. Spurs now on the inbounds. Beautiful heads-up play right there from the Spurs. As they see, there's nobody guarding the inbounder. He just pops right back in. Nice dump inside. Boris Diaw gets the dish. Splash. And that's what the San Antonio Spurs are known for, Kimri. Not being selfish, making the extra pass, and setting up the wide-open shooter. It just shows the principles of basketball never go away, no matter how much the game evolves.
Absolutely. I was going to say, it looks like for basketball, one of the biggest and most important factors, patience and awareness, and the San Antonio Spurs seem to have both.
And Boris Diaw from downtown. It's 97-80 at this point, and the Spurs are just keeping on rolling. Marjanovic gets the hoop and the foul. Matt Barnes called for that one. 100-82 as they're going to dump it in one more time to Marjanovic, and he'll stuff it home. And that's it, and that's all for Memphis, as they are finished off 116-95. San Antonio sweeps them 4-0. And speaking of the Memphis Grizzlies, Vince Carter has announced that he has no plans to retire.
Interesting.
Very interesting, given that when I was a kid, I'm talking about 8, 9, 10 years old, Vince Carter was my favorite player. I still have his Raptors bobblehead. So I'm loving that 15 is staying in the league. Half man, half amazing.
There you go.
On the winner's side, Kawhi Leonard finished with 21 points, 4 assists. LaMarcus Aldridge finished up with 10 rebounds in that game. Lance Stephenson from Memphis had a game high of 26, and Anderson finished with 13. Birdman had a rare showing. Now let's take a look at the top seed in the East. The Cleveland Cavaliers taking on the Detroit Pistons. Cleveland leads this series 3-0. This one taking place at the Palace of Auburn Hills up in Detroit, Michigan. And there goes the runaway freight train. He just cannot be stopped when he's in the lane. And right here, Shump comes up with the steal, gets it out to LeBron. Get your camera phones out, because you know something big's about to happen when LeBron's on a breakaway.
Sure. I actually read something earlier this morning saying LeBron is one of the most generous basketball players in the league. He knows when to give it to his teammates, and apparently he's doing a pretty good job of it.
Now the Pistons still hanging around here, just about 5 minutes left till halftime. We're tied at 39. Hoop and the foul for the Pistons. And now you see LeBron trying to direct his teammates. Look at J.R. Smith immediately to his right, just kind of staring at him like, what are you saying? Kyrie Irving seemed to have gotten the point. Puts a little spin cycle on, a little out of control. But check this out. That is Steph Curry-esque.
I thought for a second he lost control of that ball, but like you said, It looked like he did until he shot that hoop.
Oh, he totally lost control of the ball. He's just good enough to get it up again and put that shot up and drain it.
Get
now
it right
the Pistons,
back.
Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, don't jump for the fake, we're tied up. 78-78, Kyrie Irving, time winding down in the third. Half court. Oh, are you serious?
Beautiful.
Kyrie beats the buzzer at the end of the third quarter. That's going to be enough for Cleveland to hold on and win 100-98 as the Cavs finish off that one in a sweep as well.
Beautiful game on both behalves. LeBron James is just, I don't think he's ready to retire anytime soon, but I think he's looking really good towards the end of his career.
He's looking very good. I wouldn't even call it towards the end of his career. I still think LeBron has easily another 5, 6, 7 years to go.
Right.
But in that one, LeBron finished with 22-11. He had 6 boards, 2 steals as well. Kyrie Irving was the high point man, finishing with 31-3-5. And for the Pistons, Tobias Harris led them in scoring with 23, 13 rebounds, and 2 assists.
Beautiful, beautiful game. Now on to the NHL. We've got some playoffs for you guys on that aspect. Pittsburgh taking on the New York Rangers. In the 5th game of this series, the New York Rangers have only won 1 of these 5 games. Pittsburgh, an uncommon denominator? Beating New York is a pretty big deal for them.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think I know why the Rangers have only won 1 game. And it was those 2 guys that they just showed right there, Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin.
Absolutely. With dominance on their team, you know, Sidney only had 3 shots and 2 assists in this game, but that doesn't mean that he wasn't on that ice the entire time, leading his teammates to score and defending against the Rangers.
And
beautiful
a tough deflection.
Shot.
Yeah, just catches a deflection off of one of the Penguins' sticks right there in front of the goal. And a nice one-timer in the crease as the Penguins tie it up.
Just an absolute beautiful game for the Penguins. And as they beat the New York Rangers in this game 6-3, meaning they move on in the playoffs.
Yeah, and Pittsburgh, they've done a real good job all season long. It's good to see this carrying over to the playoffs.
Absolutely, could not agree more. And in these games, it's so intense to see this tiny little puck get into such a wide open area. Their goalies are doing a very good job of blocking this puck.
And look at that one, top shelf in the very far corner where Mama hides the Thin Mints. Hold on, can I get a replay of this? Look at this, Sid the Kid with a nice dish, no offsides, wicked.
So
finish.
Beautiful. What a beautiful game. Again, Pittsburgh 6-3 over the New York Rangers. Rust had 2 goals, 4 shots. Crosby had 3 shots, 2 assists, and Colin had 1 goal and 1 shot. A beautiful game for Pittsburgh, and hopefully in the next step of the playoffs for them, we see even bigger and better games.
Well, I mean, we should. That's what the playoffs are for. You're supposed to step up, and you're supposed to play your best hockey in the playoffs. So I think they can get it done with the players they have and the coaching staff as well.
Sure. Like you said, Crosby is dominating for Pittsburgh. But now San Jose versus the LA Kings. This is a huge moment for San Jose. I'm a San Jose fan, so it's a pretty big deal to have this 5-game series go in favor of the Sharks. In this game, we'll watch San Jose beat the Kings 6-3. Their key factor against LA, the ability to defend the puck, defend against goals, and sweep away from LA's energy that they have on the ice.
Yeah, and San Jose gets a quick goal to start the game. This one just 72 seconds in, as you have a screen set right there in front of Jonathan Quick, the keeper for the Kings, makes it hard for him to see. And here again, Quick is gonna get beat. You know, and this is the thing that surprises me the most about this series is the ease at which the Sharks are scoring. Jonathan Quick was easily one of the best top 3 goalkeepers in the NHL over the last 3 to 4 years. And to see him just getting shredded like this, you know, it's unbelievable.
It is. And like you said before, with Quick being their goalie, LA definitely was counting on a lot bigger wins and more frequent wins in this playoff series against the Sharks, but the Sharks weren't having it. They were putting in all their effort with Joe Pavelski leading the team as a strong captain. The San Jose Sharks definitely needed it. The San Jose Sharks were ranked 6th in the regular season for shots blocked, and they have one of the strongest defenses in the NHL this season. We saw Donskoy with 2 goals for San Jose, Carlson, Nieto, Tierney, and Pavelski all had 1 goal each, leading to a 6-3 win over the LA Kings. Moving on in the playoffs, the Kings are out.
And they called a slashing there. They got a penalty shot, but Jay Quick stones him cold on that one. Still let in 6 goals. I mean, you're not going to win any hockey game letting in 6 goals.
No, definitely not, unless your team is able to let in 7 goals. Or get in 7 goals, excuse me. But it wasn't that way for the Kings, unfortunately.
Yeah, and elsewhere in the NHL, the Islanders lead the Florida Panthers 3-2 in their series. The Capitals lead the Philadelphia Flyers 3-2. Dallas Stars on top of the Minnesota Wild 3-2. And the Blues and Blackhawks are tied 3-3 in the series. The Ducks and the Predators going on game 6 tonight. They lead the series 3-2.
An interesting playoff bracket for the NHL. I'm excited because the NHL is an interesting game to play hockey. It's difficult, it's kind of crazy, and there's a little bit of everything going on at all the time. So,
yeah, there's a lot to hockey.
Yeah.
You know, that the I wouldn't say the casual fan, because I'm sure the casual fan knows that, but for people that just tune in during the playoffs, there is a lot about hockey. Like you said, there's something always going on there in terms of the offsides, the icing calls, you know, the interference calls, the slashing, all that stuff. You know, the normal fan just thinks you can go out and smash on anybody, you know, at any time because it's hockey.
Yeah.
No, I mean, that's going to get you a penalty called. So a lot of stuff going on all the time in hockey. Such a great game to watch. Very intense, very exciting.
Yes.
The action basically just nonstop up and down the ice.
It is. It's a beautiful game. But that's going to do it for right now, the Around the Nation segment here on the U Sports Report. But we've got plenty more, so stay tuned.